Everything I've done in my life, I've done for my children.
It's been called Canada's Succession, the real-life drama depressing Rogers' share price. On Monday, Rogers' common shares saw their biggest sell-off since the market crash at the start of the pandemic. The Rogers family feud puts a spotlight on what can happen in a company with a dual-class share structure, set up so members of the Rogers family, who own about a third of all shares, control nearly 98% of voting power. At the center of the battle, Edward Rogers, son of the company's founder, the late Ted Rogers. He was ousted from the executive board last week after current CEO Joe Natale discovered a plan to unseat him, reportedly via pocket dial. Ironic from the head of Canada's largest wireless player. Edward retaliated by setting up his own board.
We have two boards of directors, and you can't have that in a company. You can only have one.
Edward's mother and two sisters voted to remove him. In a tweet storm this weekend, Sister Martha Rogers wrote, "I'll gladly blow up my life to stop this." Edward is taking his fight for power to BC's Supreme Court.
But I would not be surprised, given the respective deep pockets of the two sides of the family, if one of them loses in the BC Supreme Court, then I expect it'll go to the BC Court of Appeals.
Observers say the reputational damage is done.
What people might remember in the next 10 or 15 years is not the incredible success of the founder, Mr. Ted Rogers, but the dispute that is occurring.
And if the saga drags on, it could jeopardize Rogers' takeover of telecom rival Shaw, which still requires regulatory approval. This has consequences for shareholders. Rogers is widely held by pension funds and in mutual funds.
You can have family conflicts, family disputes that trump, let's call it, unbiased, impartial strategic decision making.
There's a growing push for Ottawa to look into whether dual-class share structures should continue to be allowed in Canada. Other notable publicly traded companies with this structure include Bombardier and Shaw. Anne Gaviola, Global News, Toronto.